just over the prayer. Father, we just thank you and we welcome your presence here, Lord, your comfort, your guidance, your direction. We give you the praise and the glory, Father God, that there every day we have an opportunity that is before us. And Lord, we just thank you, Father God, that Lord, that you knew exactly where she was going. We thank you that you've been part of her life and that there's so many of her family that is following you. So Lord, we give you the praise and the glory, and we just open this service to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Is there anything you guys want to share? bars. That, oh my goodness, if you were not there with her chocolate bars when she wanted them, she would send an aide to go get them.
Yes.
The importance of taking care of those little things. The little things. Those little details, like waking up and making daddy for breakfast before he would go to work or after they were retired, waking up in the middle of the night to have 2 a.m. grilled cheese sandwiches.
Gathered today to celebrate the life, and as you've just kind of shared, it just goes straight to that. And yeah, we're mourning the loss. We mourn the loss of our loved ones, but to know where they're at is worth its weight in gold. You know, and the scripture, although used quite often, it's just one that, especially with everything that's going on right now in our world, and even with Aunt June, I have a hard time saying June, and I feel like there's a part of me that should say, and yet she's still my aunt, so, you know. But, you know, and everybody's pretty familiar with it, but the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures, and he leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I thought of this scripture, and as I was meditating on just thinking about what God wanted me to say, I think about the fact that we know for a fact that God was our shepherd, and we know this, and that's such a great relief. We also know that he leads us, and no matter what's going on, he's right there with us. I think of the scripture, that part that it says, lo, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Because death has no power over us if we're a Christian. We have the glorious hope of what's to come. And yet, on that same aspect, we're walking through the valley. We're not camping out. We're not just waiting for it. We're going through it. And there's some of the greatest fruits we've done. So much of that scripture is so, if we take it apart and we think about how much he comforts us, and we can walk with him and talk with him no matter what's going on. He's always there. He never leaves us or forsakes us. And even there's times when we go through trials and tribulations, you know, and Jesus said we would have these things. But yet, so many times, we want to blame God when it's usually, you know, it's never God's doing. But it's so many times we got to find somebody to blame. But yet, God's always there going, come on, let me pick you back up. Let me walk with you. You know, we've seen Engine go through so much. You know, first she was going downhill, then she really came back up for a while, and then she went. But you know what? That just, you know, I look at that, and sometimes I think that's just kind of God showing off, because he can. Now, maybe some people think that's crazy, but that's just the way I look at it, because, you know, we prayed. We prayed, and God moved. So, in this aspect, you know, we know, and we, you know, the family mourns the loss, but yet we also rejoice where she's at. And you know, one of the things that came to me, and I just want to say, at least I had to write it down because it came to me in this way. So at times like these, we are comforted by memories, and you've shared some of these, and each one of you have memories of the ones that we love. You know, so many times we go through and we've lost a lot of loved ones, but yet the memories we can always hang on to, no matter where we're at, no matter what's going on. And though we're sad for our loss, we do not grieve as those who have no hope. We know to be absent from the body is to be present from the Lord. And as we look at that, you know, and you know, Mary, even as you shared, you know where she's at. She's walking the streets of gold. You know, there is no more pain. There's no more sickness. There's no more of all that stuff. She don't have to worry about it. You know, she's feasting at the table of the Father. You know, and that is so awesome. You know, and so many times we have to look at the fact that we make it so hard that if there's anybody that doesn't know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, you know, it's so simple and we make it so hard. And the scripture, you know, that always everybody knows is John 3:16. But yet I wanted to bring 15 in there, and it said that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. If we stop and think about it, are you a whosoever today? Or some translations just say whoever. But see, we're all whoever. We all have the opportunity to come to him. You know, and it's never too late. As long as there's breath, there's hope. So in that aspect, you know, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, don't waste time. Don't pass it up. And I come back with that to the point, you know, people say, well, it's so hard. No, we make it hard. Our mind makes it hard. We think if, you know, something could be where I could go and I could drop $100 or $1,000 and I could be saved, I could have bought it because we feel like we've done something. But it's a free gift. And, you know, even in Romans it says that if you confess with your mouth that Jesus, that Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God is raising from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So today, if there's anybody that's hearing this that doesn't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, just ask him to forgive you. Come into your life and be the Lord of your life. I know without a question that would be Aunt June's total wish for every one of her family. Is when that trumpet sounds, when that time comes, that you're there and you can all gather together and rejoice again. That's a promise you can take to the bank. And it's awesome. It's awesome. You want to play the next song? Oh.
have made. I see the stars. I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to with shouts of acclamation, and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I'll bow down with humble adoration. Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
Your presence has been revealed, Father God, and Lord, as we commit this shell body to the grave, Father God. Lord, we thank you, Father, for the promise that you've given us. We thank you and rejoice that you are the Lord. Lord, we just thank you that Jesus died on the cross for us to prepare the way, that you sent your Son to pay it all. We just give you the praise and the glory, Father God, and we ask, Lord, that you would comfort each family member and friend. May they be comforted by your word, encouraged through happy memories, and be sustained by the hope of the resurrection. For all who place their faith in you shall be saved. Father, we just give you the praise and the glory, Father God. This body is just the shell, that you already rejoicing June in heaven. That the mother-in-law, grandma, great-grandma, all of these titles, many more. And most of all, she's your child. And we thank you for that she's there with you. Bless this family, Father God. Guide them and direct them in their steps. May they always follow your will. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thanks for being here, guys. Thanks for letting me be.